football stars are known to earn millions thanks to their performance on the pitch. And some of them are even richer if we only take into account their off-the-pitch earnings. Perfume, sodas, watches, clothing, cars. Almost everything you can think of becomes a source of income for these guys. But there are only a few select sports people who became billionaires. And in football, the ratio gets even more stretched. In 2020, Forbes carried a report based on the information provided by football and financial experts, clubs, players, agents, and commercial sponsors. That concluded that only two footballers in history are known to have become billionaires. Do you have an idea of who we're actually talking about? I think it's time to talk money, baby. Money Time, episode 10, here we go. All right, let's cut the suspense right here. By now, you should know who we're talking about, if you consider yourself a football fan. Yes, Leo Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo have given us an era of complete football frenzy with their unbelievable number of goals, records broken, and all that other stuff. And they have reached the upper echelons of football by becoming the only footballers in history to have earned $1 billion throughout their careers. But before we go deep into the numbers and reveal some crazy sums, let's explain why they earn so much with five simple reasons. Number one, they are the best players of their generation, by far. They have won 10 consecutive Ballon d'Ors. Number two, each one is sponsored by the top two sports brands in the world, so that's a lot of money. Number three, they played in the same country for two of the fiercest enemies during their primes. Number four, therefore, it was a rivalry also amplified by Spanish and international media. And number five, they boast two completely different styles of play. They are the perfect rivals from a sporting and marketing standpoint, but we are going to focus on how they actually got there. Players' wages, numerous endorsement deals, milestone bonuses. These guys blink and they earn hundreds of thousands of dollars. So let's rewind a year. 2020, crazy year, right? That's when our dear friends at Forbes stated that CR7 became the first football player ever to reach billionaire status. Bravo. It was mentioned he was just the third athlete to do it while still being active. And he was also the first member of a sporting team to achieve this milestone. He actually made $117 million that year alone, with more than 40% of his income, that's $47 million, coming from endorsement deals only. By then, his fortune had risen up to the $400 million mark. He was only behind tennis player Roger Federer, rapper Kanye West, and model Kylie Jenner when it came to his earnings in 2020, and joined Tiger Woods and Floyd Mayweather as the richest active sportsmen in the whole world. Not bad, my guy. Although Messi, on the other hand, made $126 million during the same period, making him the highest paid footballer on the planet that year. Crazy! Talk about La Pulga. Over a year ago, the footballing world exploded with the news coming from Barcelona that he wanted out of the club, which saw him debut in the pros in 2004. Interviews and public statements were shared, and the backlash against the Argentinian was common currency during the days and months which followed. But the worst of the hits came from his own club. They were the ones putting out the details of his contract for everyone to see, in order to mark him as the biggest culprit for why the club went adrift. The drama was followed by a report made by Spanish outlet El Mundo, stating in January 2021 that his contract was worth $674 million and was therefore the reason why the club had gotten themselves in the dark waters of a succulent debt. It was so obscene that the title read, "The huge contract of Leo Messi that ruins Barcelona." I mean, come on, really? The guy who gave you 35 titles and millions in revenue by himself? Almost by himself. And like the song goes, "God only knows what I'll do without you." Well, now they know. But anyways, it was useful information, so thanks, FC Barcelona. Not only did you lose Messi, you are also helping this show with valuable details, because that was the contract that made it possible for Messi to catch CR7 as the second billionaire of football in the latter months of 2020. But hold on for a second. It's important here to clarify that becoming a billionaire doesn't mean having $1 billion to spend on thousands of cars or even buying a few countries, if that were possible. but it says that the person has reached a sum of $1 billion earned throughout his entire career. And even if we are talking about estimations, these numbers come from good sources and allow us to understand the immense wealth the biggest stars of the biggest sport in the world have. Taken into account, both sporting salaries and endorsement contracts in this case. But this race to become a billionaire wasn't a deliberate competition in order to see who has the largest influx of money. It was merely just a product of their parallel careers, which started in 2002 and 2004, respectively, and their value as football stars and advertisement gold mines. In other words, it was bound to happen. Coming back to this year, the latest report is that through May 2021, the time when seasons normally finish, Leo Messi set a record in earnings for footballers with his estimated $130 million. That comes from adding his juicy endorsements, like the deal he has with Adidas and other multinationals, which brought him to the sum of $33 million. With a $97 million football salary, that's more than $10 million a month, $2 million a week. He's made it out, man. He's made of money, baby, just like this show. That dough turned out to be more than most people thought he was making, as that infamous leak contract showed. Also, as of today, Lionel Messi's net worth is approximately $400 million, according to many sources. As for Ronaldo, he came in second this year again, with the then Juventus man earning around $120 million in the same period. Regarding the Madeira-born's fortune, it sits today at an estimated $450 million, making him the richest soccer player in the world overall. And that's also in part because of the reach his social media accounts have. They are in fact another multi-million dollar industry in themselves. Everything has its place in CR7's profiles, where half of his posts are product related. Counting with a growing fan base, he was the first person to reach 500 million followers between his Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter accounts. Bravo again. And today, he has more than 590 million of them. That's more than the population of the USA and Brazil put together. And guess what? Yeah, you get the idea. That translates into tons of millions per year in advertising sums. Up to $1.6 million per Instagram post in 2021, according to social media analytics firm Hopper. That's also similar with Messi, who reportedly earns $1.1 million per post. You want another cool fact? In total, between the first hint of a video showing Messi with the colors of PSG this summer, until the Argentinian's first press conference, the club made more than 30 posts on social media, earning many millions of views in the process. That's a huge outlet for the club's own brand positioning, their sponsors, and the player himself. Also, ESPN recently paid La Liga $1,400 million for the rights to broadcast the championship in the US during the next 8 years. That was before Messi left. That explains the incomparable importance these type of players have on everything that surrounds them. They are literally attention magnets. If you still don't believe me, just take this fact. CR7 will make Manchester United the most viewed team in the world this season by bringing in 60 million viewers with him just by putting on the shirt and taking on the pitch. No wonder they become billionaires. They generate billions. Billions! In fact, in a time when the sporting world has been impacted economically because of the pandemic, European clubs registered losses of $8,500 million in revenue during the 2021 season, according to KPMG, a global assurance and consulting network which focuses on financial and fiscal matters. And even in this context, Messi and CR7 managed to engross their fortunes regarding the previous year. Of course, they will continue to do so, as the rivalry will apparently write another chapter after it was announced that the Portuguese will regain his spot as the highest paid athlete in the world by the end of this current season in May 2022 by making around $125 million in gross earnings, with $55 million coming from endorsements, whereas Messi will earn $110 million, gaining a significantly lesser $35 million from commercial revenue. As you see, the fight is still on between Leo and Cristiano. So that brings us to the end of the video. We've told you who were the only football stars who became billionaires, and you liked it, and how they managed to achieve that milestone. Messi and Cristiano. Cristiano and Messi, going head-to-head in the pursuit of scoring the most goals, winning the most titles, and earning the most money. Before you go, since we're talking about money here, baby, have you ever wondered about how the industry of football works and why do football players earn so much of it? If so, we have a video explaining that for you with tons of details and examples that will make you an expert on the topic. So feel free to click and watch. Now you know that only two footballers had reached billionaire status. Who do you think will be the next one to catch up with them? Neymar, Mbappe, Haaland, De Bruyne? Leave your answers in the comments. We'd love to hear what you think. See you soon.